Good evening, and welcome to Not the Show. I'm Joe.
And I am Mondo.
That was Gouge Away by the Pixies.
The Pixies.
I think they're playing in the city soon.
Really?
Yeah, Jen keeps saying, we should go see the Pixies. And I'm like, okay.
You should go see the Pixies.
Yeah. I might be lying. No. I specifically remember. They're definitely playing in the city soon. Or they just played. I might have missed it.
Deformed child. Not the Pixies.
Me.
No, not you. My goodness.
How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
I'm okay. I'm scarred for life, but we'll talk about that in a bit.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
That's a good one. What you been up to?
Work. Man, my life is like really boring.
Mine too.
This is the highlight of my week.
If I didn't have a kid, I suppose there'd be much less going on in my life than there is. He takes a lot of time up.
He does. Kids do. I don't know. Not JoJo specifically, but kids do. They do take a lot of time.
Yeah.
You got to do stuff with them. You got to make sure they're sleeping. You got to make sure they eat. You got to make sure they take baths.
True.
Go to school.
There was lice this week, so that was exciting.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I don't think I talked about it last show.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
We did not have the lice talk.
It's the usual kid thing. Came home from school with it, I'm sure.
Is that why you got a do-rag on?
No, it's a hat, too.
Okay. It's backwards.
Yeah, it's got no thing.
I thought maybe you shaved your head.
I did not.
Lice.
No. It just felt like I was a hat kind of day.
Nice.
Once in a while. We did the shampoo and we didn't shave his head.
That's good.
Shampoo, fine tooth comb. I didn't do anything. Jen did it.
That's also good.
I was recovering from my broken back all week. So.
Broken back?
I did talk about that last week.
We did talk about that last week. Yes, we did.
Yeah, I'm better there, though. I'm able to walk, at least. That's good.
Oh, man.
That was a good one. I did it good to myself. But I'm better. I can function normally just about.
Just about.
Yeah, just about. Not quite. I still won't pick things up. And I'm still sitting on the couch and not helping around the house. And, you know, Jen doesn't quite know how real or fake my back is to avoid doing stuff around the house.
Right.
But, yeah. But I'm feeling better.
That's good. That's the important thing.
Thanks, yeah.
Heal.
I'm healing.
Heal.
I am. At the shop, definitely I don't lift anything. How old is he now? He's 26 years older than me. I'm 40. My 66-year-old dad gets to carry all the boxes around. It's his own fault. He's the one who broke my back in the first place.
Now, how did he break your back again?
He just had me moving.
Talk about.
He just had me moving boxes. It's part of my job. I just happened to just the wrong box at the wrong time, and I overextended. And anyway, enough about my back.
That will do it.
Yeah. But yeah, that's it. I didn't have anything going on this week either. I went to a communion party, and that was fun. I saw my friends. That was it. There was a magician.
Magicians are fun.
Yeah, she made balloon animals, and there was a rabbit. otherwise, I had a boring week. Except for the fact that I was scarred for life today.
Yeah, that's never any fun.
Being scarred for life?
Yeah, being scarred for life, no fun.
No fun at all.
Being scarred for life ain't fun.
No.
You know who's got an interesting life?
Who?
Angie's mom, Mary Ellen.
Does she?
Yeah. She's got so much going on. You know, she's still, her husband is much better. He suffered that stroke a few years ago.
Mm-hmm.
But he's just kind of funny. He called Angie today at school just to say hi. She was in class. So, of course, you know, she answered because she didn't know if it was important or not.
Of course.
You know, it's just him just saying hi. So, but, you know, she keeps fostering dogs. She takes in all these foster dogs. And, you know, that's always interesting and exciting. But the other day she calls me up and she's just like, you know, so what's new with you? And I'm like, yeah, nothing. I work. I come home. You know, I take care of our daughter, you know, which is easier and easier as she gets older. And, you know, that is my life. She's like, well, I'm glad I called you. You're interesting. Yeah, I'll talk to you later. And I'm just like, wait a second. I said, you got like the craziest shit going on. You tell me what's going on in your life. You know, and she was able to like fill half an hour.
Nice. See, that's
perfect. Yeah, because, you know, she's got crazy shit going on in her life all the time.
I got people in my life like that, too.
The craziest people we know.
My friend Dean keeps taking in animals. I think he just took in three kittens or four, two kittens recently.
Kittens are fun.
Yeah, he's a big animal guy, though. He loves his animals. He's got three dogs and several cats.
Yeah, I see the animal, the dog posts on
the Facebook.
What do you call it? The Facebook, yes.
Did you see my friend's Facebook friended you this week?
Yes. Yes, I have two new Facebook friends.
Right. They were talking about you, and I was like, you should Facebook friend him if you're going to talk about him. And so they did.
You're going to talk about him.
Yeah. You might as well be Facebook friends with him if you're going to talk about him in this thread. It was like a comment thread on something I posted. Yeah, so they friended you this week. So I'll tell you what happened to me at work today, then.
Yeah, I want to hear.
Since there's not much going on, and we have some like movie and book and Stephen King news. We'll do that after the break. But let's talk about what happened to me at work. So I don't know if I've ever talked about work on the show. I'm a printer and I design things like on computers, you know, the graphic design and stuff. So this woman comes in. She owns a beauty salon like two doors down from my shop. She's very short, little woman about this tall. She's black, and she's about 300 pounds. Big woman. She comes in with her phone. She's got an Android phone. And she says, "I need to give you these pictures." I said, "Well, why don't you email me the pictures?" She said, "I need you to put them together and do some Photoshop magic like I do and turn it into a business card." All right. So she says, "I don't know how to email the pictures." And I take her phone. I was like, "I don't know how to do it either. It's an Android phone. I'm sure I could figure it out if I bothered to want to try."
Sure.
But, so I was like, "I don't know how to do this." She's like, "They're in my Dropbox." I said, "Okay." So I logged out of my own Dropbox. I logged into hers. And I click on the photo tab on the bottom. And her photos start to slowly download and appear.
Oh no!
And I'm like,
do I know where this is going?
I'm ready for the pictures I want. I only need these two pictures, beauty salon pictures, pictures of hair. And as they start downloading, towards the bottom of the page, the naked pictures of the giant fat woman start appearing. And not just naked pictures, right? First, you know, just like bed selfie, like laying on bed and picture of herself,
right?
Naked. And then as it's loading further, I'm trying to scroll away, right? I'm scrolling, but the pictures are loading, so it won't scroll while the pictures are loading. It's downloading. I can't scroll. I can't switch away. She's like, "Oh." I was like, "What?" And I try not to look. And as it comes further and further down the page, there's the ones of her holding her phone between her legs start appearing.
Oh, and you're holding this phone.
Close up of her. And I it was seriously traumatic for me. I was like, "Oh my God, what are we looking at?" She said, "Do all my phone pictures go onto the Dropbox?" And I was like, "I'm sure it asked you, would you like to back up all of your photos on Dropbox, because I know it asked me on my phone."
Yeah, it asks me too.
Said, "You must have said yes." She said, "Oh."
Number one reason I no longer take nudies of myself or others.
She just said, "Oh." And so I closed it. I just closed it. I was like, "Let me see if I can figure out how to email those instead." And so I took her phone from her and I emailed them to myself.
You should have just taken her phone from her. End of sentence.
You don't deserve this.
She's a danger to herself and others.
You're not using this right. Who could possibly want those pictures?
Oh.
What's the one where they disappear after?
Snapchat.
Try Snapchat. At least they vanish then.
Sort of. Yeah, you can always get them.
And you could screen cap yourself, but yeah.
Yeah, you can screen cap them. You can, you know, they're in buffers and stuff. There's, you know.
But she doesn't even know how to turn off Dropbox syncing. I'm sure she wouldn't be able to figure out how to save a Snapchat anymore. So I was traumatized today.
Yeah, oh my goodness.
Yeah, it was not fun.
I would imagine not.
I was a little horrified. I'm glad my dad's around. Sometimes he hovers over my shoulder, see what's going on, what I'm doing.
Right.
He wasn't there.
Out of curiosity or just
working? No, yeah. Sometimes he helps with deal. He does the pricing while I'm dealing with the art, and he gives his input on whatever he likes, the way something looks, or stuff like that. But yeah, he wasn't hanging around. I didn't even tell him. I didn't even want to think about it again.
Jeez, I don't blame you. Who would want to? Poor lady.
Yeah, and then she had to come back, and she's got to face me now. You know, I designed her thing, and she came and see it, and she said, I've got another logo for you. I was like, I'm not touching your phone. She's like, no, I'll bring it tomorrow. So I was like, so I'm actually going to come back tomorrow, and I'm going to have to talk to do it all over again. No more Dropbox. And I purposefully don't do that. I don't like to, my go-to is always, can you just email me the file? I got a big poster on the wall, my email address on it, so that I could just point at it and say, send me that from there. But some of these people, they don't have email set up on their phone. Not tech people. They know how to take pictures, they can text, but not only don't they have email set up on their phone, but they have no idea how to do that, even if they did have it set up on their phone.
Right.
So I try to make everybody, but then they bring in, some people come in with USB drives, some people want me to just go to their emails. And I'm like, all right, I can log into your Hotmail, I guess, and download things and print. I get a lot of people that want me to log into their emails. They just give me their passwords, too. Why don't you type your own password in? Eh, I don't care. That's brilliant.
People just, are crazy.
Yeah, they are. Really crazy. Anyway, that's my story from today.
I have no traumatic stories.
No, huh?
No.
That's good. You're better off. Better off not being traumatized.
Amen to that.
I have my scan tomorrow. That's in the news.
Oh, yes.
My yearly. I'm sure it'll be unpleasant.
They always are. Exactly what do they have to do?
They are either doing a PET scan or a CT scan. And if it's either way, I got to drink like a quart of this nasty tasting stuff that they could then track in my stomach. Yeah, no, it's not barium. It's just something that they're able to then see on the scan.
Okay.
I don't remember what it's called. And then they'll inject some kind of a tracer in my blood as well, and they'll trace that with the machine. If it's a PET scan, it's a radioactive isotope. They come in with like a metal box, and then a shielded metal box, and they open the shielded metal box, and they take out this big metal syringe that they then inject. And then PET scan, then they just scan me. If it's a CT scan, they actually hook me up to like an IV, and they push it while I'm in the machine. The radioactive one, I have to sit and wait a half hour after I'm injected because it flows around while I'm waiting.
Right.
And the other one, they push. All of it is generally unpleasant. The PET, the one with the radioactive, they give me a letter that lets me be able to go to airports without getting arrested for bringing radioactive material into airports.
Right.
And I'm not supposed to touch babies. Doesn't that sound healthy?
That does sound. That's.
It's only once a year, but still.
Now, how long can you not touch babies for?
It's usually 24 hours.
Okay.
So I got that tomorrow, and I can't eat until after the scan, so I'll starve most of the day. I'm bringing everybody down. Sorry to bring the show down.
No.
It's just a test, everyone. I haven't been sick in 5 years. Okay, so now we're past that. That's all I've got going on in my life, and you've got your life.
Yeah, nothing going on in my life.
You know what I did see today? I saw the new trailer for Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh yeah, so did I.
Yeah, that looks pretty awesome. Every time I see trailers for that, I'm like, I didn't know what this was gonna be. When I first saw the first trailer, I was like, I've never read the comics. I don't even know any of the story behind them.
Right.
And I was like, this looks cool. Like this, I've heard of Rocket Raccoon. The others I probably never heard of. I don't know why I might have heard of Rocket Raccoon and not the others.
Well, Rocket's been around like I have no idea why you would have heard of Rocket Raccoon. You're not like a comic book guy,
right? I'm not.
But you know, Rocket Raccoon's like mad cool, so it kind of makes sense to me.
I saw this T-shirt today.
Yeah.
That I almost bought. I don't know if I'll find it. I tried to buy it. It was sold out in my size, but it was a Rocket Raccoon shirt, and it was really, really pretty cool. But I couldn't buy it. They were sold out. I was annoyed. Not even a Rocket Raccoon fan, but the shirt was so cool.
Rocket Raccoon is awesome.
So yeah, the new trailer looks good.
Yeah, it does.
I'm looking forward to it. I don't know when it's out. End of the summer?
August 1st.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, it is.
Can't wait. Also, this week, Godzilla came out. Godzilla made like $100 million opening weekend. Like, surprise hit. No one thought it was going to make any money.
No. Well, I mean, I think they thought it was going to make, like, they were estimating, like, I think 70 million was, like, their top estimate.
Mm-hmm.
That's where, like, they were like, you know, that's the most this movie's going to make.
Yeah, it did better.
I saw a marquee for Godzilla. Like, I saw it on the internet, so, I mean, for all I know, it could be fake. Didn't look fake. But it said 100% less Matthew Broderick. Poor Matthew Broderick.
I liked the Matthew Broderick version. I didn't love it.
I didn't love it either, but I enjoyed it. It was fun, you know. You don't have to... Not every movie has to be a... good movie. Not every movie has to be a good movie.
No, but I don't know. I thought it had its moments, I guess is the way to put it. I don't know about all the baby Godzillas everywhere. That was a bit...
Baby Godzillas were kind of irritating.
Yeah, but the rest I liked, you know.
They tried to make a more realistic lizard Godzilla.
Yeah.
And they did. You know, Hank Azaria was in it. Hank Azaria is good in anything he does.
Yeah, he was good. And the French secret agent guy, he what's his name?
Leon.
Yeah.
Leon the Professional.
That's right, the guy from The Professional. He's great, too. And he was good in that movie, too.
I can't remember his name for the life of me.
It doesn't matter. But the Bryan Cranston's in the new one, and I'm looking forward to seeing it. I'm going to try and see it in the theater if I can.
I like Bryan Cranston.
Me, too.
Now, we were talking about him once on the show, about how he was, I think it was last year, was the year of Bryan Cranston.
Right, the last summer, the last movie draft game we played, he was in like half the movies.
Yeah. And it does not stop. Nope. The man is a juggernaut.
And Breaking Bad was amazing. Did you watch any Breaking Bad?
Oh, yeah.
Breaking Bad was great. I came into it late, but early enough to like catch the last three episodes of the series. I just caught up. I was done with all the catch-up, and there was like three episodes left, and it was kind of perfect timing.
Breaking Bad was... The end was... I can't believe we didn't talk about this at all on the show.
We were off for like 6 months when it
ended.
That's
true. We were off for the entire finale of Breaking Bad. We missed a lot of things being off.
We did. We did sort of a recap when we came back.
We talked about things like Almost Human, which
Doctor Who
canceled.
And we talked about the Doctor Who stuff. Have you been watching Warehouse? Warehouse is on tonight's the series finale of Warehouse 13.
You know, I have. They're all DVR'd, just waiting for me to watch it.
Same for me. I watched the first one, and I thought maybe I'd save the rest for. I'll watch them all at once. Those, you know, the five in a row.
Right.
I did like the first one back. I missed that show. It's a good show.
Yeah.
I also miss the other Sci-Fi Channel show that ended while we were on hiatus. The one with the town with all the geniuses.
Oh, Eureka.
Yeah, that ended while we were on hiatus also.
It It did.
I loved that show.
Eureka was another very good show.
Yeah. They end on high notes. I guess that's the point.
Yeah.
And the guy, the lead from Eureka, moved over to Haven, which is a Stephen King series.
You know, I started to watch that. And that's about it. Sorry. You know, and I'm really enjoying it because I don't know if you remember, I was not watching it.
Right.
For no other reason than just I just hadn't gotten around to watching it. And I have started to watch it, and I am enjoying it, but I kind of stopped, so I'm gonna have to really get back to it.
It's very good. I like it every week. I feel like it's underrated, and I don't know how many years left it's got, but I like it.
You know, I was waiting for it to come on the Netflix, which it has.
Awesome. What else this week? Did you watch Game of Thrones?
No.
No Game of Thrones.
No.
Game of Thrones still good.
I'm so you know, and now that we're doing the show again, like on a weekly basis, I probably should try to make some time to watch these damn things.
It's all right. There's news. We'll play a song and we'll come back with the news. We'll regroup.
We'll regroup.
Yeah, we're gonna regroup and we'll talk about a bunch of Stephen King news this week, and see what you think of the new Ben Affleck as Batman. We've got our first pictures of Ben Affleck as Batman in the new Batmobile. Talk about that for a minute.
Sure.
And I got to pick a song, so I.
Yeah, because I was a little slack on song number two.
Oh, that's cool. How about some Wolf Mother? We'll be right back.
the joke around the thief, sir.
That was Joker and the Thief by Wolf Mother.
I've never heard that song.
Yeah?
You know, I to be honest, I feel like a poser. Not a poser, because I've never claimed to be a Wolf Mother fan. But, you know, I'm supposed to really like music. The only Wolf Mother song I've ever heard is what is that, Woman?
Yeah.
Woman! Something, I don't know. That being a woman or something.
Joker and the Thief is a bit of a deeper track.
Yeah, I like that. At first I thought it was Woman. Because I was just like, oh yeah, Wolf Mother, and like I heard it and I was just like, oh yeah, this is that woman's song. And then I was like, oh no, it's not. I suck.
I wasn't gonna play. I couldn't play Woman. It's too well known.
Yeah.
Well, I played Wood exactly. Last week. But
Wood is a very awesome song.
It is, and I had to go a little. I do like that the Wolf Mother album. So I've seen them live. They put on a great show too.
I've never seen them.
They rock. All right. So stuff's going on. Ben Affleck is Batman. Would you seen the picture?
I have.
Any thoughts?
Yeah, I have not had a problem with the whole Batfleck thing whatsoever. I am a firm supporter of Batfleck.
I put his I put the picture in your instead of your head, so anybody who hasn't seen it can see. So, yeah, there's a whole meme going on at the moment about sad Batman, and so there's some people put ice cream on the side of the Batmobile because he needs ice cream, and it's like a sad Batman internet meme this week. But
I've seen a couple of pictures of other people as Batman. I can't think of one of them now.
I kind of like the look. It's a little old school. It reminds me of the look of Superman, which I guess it should because it's the same dude as the rebooted Superman, right?
Right. This is their lead up into their Justice League movie.
Right.
They're also going to have Wonder Woman in it.
Yeah.
Lord knows who else.
Jesse Eisenberg will be starring as Lex Luthor. Gal Gadot will play Wonder Woman.
Gal Gadot.
I like the look of the Batmobile too. I think I liked the Michael Keaton Batmobile better than the realistic tank looking Batmobiles that he's had lately.
Right.
In the Whispering Batman movies. They were going for something much more realistic than the older movies. And I suppose that's a decent direction to go when you're trying to get away from the silliness that Batman and Robin and ended up with, the Mr. Freeze, all that silly, hokey stuff.
Right. You know, I really liked the first two Burton Batman movies. You know, I had issues with them. Man, is that like my catchphrase on the show? Yeah, I had an issue with it.
Maybe you have issues with a lot of
things.
I
liked it.
This is the second week in a row, the third, or maybe 2 weeks ago, we spoke about Batman, so.
This is the Batman podcast.
I guess so.
But, yeah, for instance, like, you know, Batman is not a killer, you know, and he was killing an awful lot of people in that first Batman.
Yeah.
You know, and people hated Batman Returns, which was the second Batman with the Penguin and Catwoman. And yeah, you know, it wasn't perfect, but I liked it. I thought it was pretty good. I liked the mood. I liked the atmosphere of the movie, and I thought it was a pretty good Batman movie. And people didn't like it at all. And, you know, I'd like to think that a lot of those people look back at that movie fondly after they started making, like, Batman Forever, you know, Batman and Robin, Batman and the Girl from Clueless.
You didn't like the Jim Carrey...
Oh, Jesus, no. No.
Who was Two-Face?
Two-Face, of all people, is Harvey Lee Jones.
That's right.
Did I get his name right? Is that his name?
Something Lee Jones.
Yeah.
Harvey? I don't think it's Harvey. Harvey Dent.
Yeah, it's Harvey Dent. It's
Harvey Dent.
He was Harvey
Dent. Tommy Lee Jones.
Tommy Lee Harvey Lee Jones.
I just watched Man in Black 3, so I should really remember Tommy Lee Jones.
Tommy Lee Jones was a terrible Two-Face.
Yeah.
Jim Carrey was a terrible Riddler. Mr. Freeze wasn't in that one, right?
No, I think that was the one before.
Right, Mr. Freeze is the one with like Poison Ivy and
Alicia Silverstone and
Drew Barrymore.
Andrew Barrymore, yeah.
Drew Barrymore was like in it for like a minute. I don't even remember who she was.
And Mary. Oh, no, it wasn't Mary. It was, who played Poison Ivy?
Uma Thurman.
Uma Thurman.
Uma. Mm-hmm. Uma Thurman was, who the fuck was Drew Barrymore? She's in the movie. And Drew Barrymore is not nobody.
You'd
think she'd have a name.
I don't remember.
I mean, they put Alicia Silverstone in that movie. You'd think they'd give Drew Barrymore something better to do. You'd think they would have let Drew Barrymore be Batgirl.
Was she Mr. Freeze's dying wife that he had frozen in a box somewhere?
No, she might have just been like one of his lackeys. She was nobody cool whatsoever. And I think she even got some sort of like billing. Like not top billing, of course, but she got some like billing. It was like Drew Barrymore in.
Mm.
You know, Batman Forever.
I don't remember at all her being in it.
Because she was in it for like a minute. Just so that they could say, look, we got Drew Barrymore in this movie.
Was she that famous at the time that they needed her to say that Drew Barrymore was in it?
I think she was making her comeback. She was starting to do, you know, she was no longer the little girl lost. She was doing like a, I think around that time she was doing some of them romances, like Boys on the Side. And it was about that era.
Okay. Was it like...
I think.
Hmm. Well, speaking...
She wasn't nobody anymore. She was on her way back.
Since we're talking about her anyway, let's talk about Firestarter.
Firestarter.
Was Firestarter a Stephen King movie you liked?
Yes, absolutely.
So, Entertainment Weekly reporting this week that there's going to be a TV series on TNT based on Firestarter and The Shop, which was the evil government agency from Firestarter.
Which was one of the best things Stephen King ever did until he started tying The Dark Tower into everything.
Right, The Shop was around in several books, right?
Oh, yeah. The Shop was around in several books, yes.
I want to say Dead Zone. Was
I'm blanking on a bunch of them. But, Tommyknockers, The Shop was involved in Tommyknockers.
Right.
You know, not much, I mean, but he mentioned them. He's good at that.
Yeah, yeah. Subtle ties. So it's going to be about The Shop attempting to exploit her powers. Oh, 20 years later, and she's tracked down, and and one of the Shop's former members introduces her to other people with powers.
Twisted Firestarter.
So her and this retired Shop agent and all these other people with their own abilities are going to try and find the Shop and destroy it for good. So sounds pretty typical. We all have powers, and there's going to be some sort of monster of the week finding the next person with powers, and some will be good guys and some will be bad guys, and the background story behind it all will be that they're trying to destroy the Shop. But there's going to be a fine line between whether the Shop is doing good or doing bad, because some of these people deserve to be locked up. Am I being too negative about it?
No, not at all. I mean it. No, not at all.
It might be okay.
You know, it probably will. Well, who's doing it?
TNT.
They've done something pretty good recently, haven't they?
Written by Robbie Thompson of Supernatural, produced by James Middleton, who did Terminator Sarah Connor Chronicles, and Jamie Paglia, who's from Eureka.
I liked Sarah Connor Chronicles. I did not think the Sarah Connor Chronicles sucked. So that's good.
So maybe it'll be all right.
Yeah, I think so. It's like, how bad can they fuck it up? Like famous last words, right?
Did you watch the Did you watch the Dead Zone TV series with Anthony Michael Hall ever?
Yes, and then I stopped.
Same here. I watched a few.
And not because I disliked it, but just because it wasn't the best thing on television, which, again, not a dig, but, I mean, there were other things I was trying to watch at the time. And, you know, I don't remember what night it was on. I think it wasn't on a great night.
Mm-hmm.
And if I had a DVR at that time, it was probably filled up with other things I was watching. And I always, you know, I would always like, yeah, it's going to be in syndication. I'll catch up eventually. You know, now we have things like Netflix. Is it on Netflix?
I'm not sure.
Dead Zone. But I like the Dead Zone.
It was an interesting story to pick to turn into a series. There was a lot of ways to, you know, stretch the one 400-page book into more.
Right.
And that always makes for a good story when it's something that's, you know, manageable like that. So Gerald's Game is going to become a movie. It was announced this week at Cannes that Gerald's Game will be a movie written by Mike Flanagan, written and directed by Mike Flanagan, who did Oculus.
This name sounds fake.
He did Oculus, which is that movie that's out now starring Karen Gillian.
Oh, yeah, that was a... that looked good. I haven't seen it, but that looks good.
I haven't seen it either. But I think it did all right. It was in the theater a few weeks at least. So it's going to be... They're going to start right away on Gerald's Game, which it was going to be. They pushed another movie out of the way so they can do it. And now, Gerald's Game is one of the most intense and compelling novels I've ever read. This has been a dream project for many years. Blah blah blah.
Is it? Not you, but you know, whoever said that. Is it? Because
the whole movie takes place.
I would have to reread it, but she was chained to a bed.
Yes. Her husband chained to the bed. I'm not sure if her husband then died.
I think he died.
He died with her chained to a bed.
Right. Like he had a heart attack or something. Like they were in a sex up and she was chained to the bed. It was all romantic.
Yeah.
And then he keeled over and died.
Right. And it's about her trying to escape and about whether or not she's hallucinating that someone is tormenting her from across the room, hiding in the shadows of the house, right?
It's like Misery without Annie Wilkes.
Right. Without
once
actually...
again, not a dig at the book. I mean, I enjoyed the book. I just don't know how well it'll translate to... Without... Yeah, it might, man. People go see all sorts of movies that are terrible.
Right, and she never gets...
I'm not even saying it'll be terrible. Listen to me. I'm such a negative Norbert.
She never gets touched either. The psycho or the imaginary psycho doesn't do it. And freaks her out, I think.
Right. I'd really have to reread it, and this could be spoiler material for anyone who's never read the book and maybe planning on seeing the movie. So you can, like, I don't know, plug up your ears or skip ahead a couple seconds. But he was there, wasn't he? Wasn't there something there?
Yeah, I think he was there. Because she went to his trial, right? He was some criminal, some escaped criminal. And in the court, after he was, I don't know if convicted or not, but he saw her and he put his arms up like he was handcuffed to the bed.
Right.
And he said something like, save me, let me out of here, or whatever she had been yelling at him or the imaginary him. So, yeah, it turned out.
Shot.
Right, something like that.
Did she?
I don't know.
I have to reread this.
Again, it wasn't one of my favorites, so I think I've only read it once.
Yeah, me too. I mean, again, I mean, not a bad book whatsoever.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, it's not something you're going to want to reread over and over again. Unlike some of the other books. I mean, a lot of Stephen King stuff I like to read over and over again simply because always finding something new.
Yeah. And it was in the Eclipse series of books, which was also Dolores Claiborne was in that same
bunch. During the big eclipse.
Right, during the eclipse. And that's when it happened, when he was tormenting her during the eclipse.
Kathy Bates was in that one.
Yeah.
Not as Annie Wilkes.
Right.
As
someone else.
Some lady who...
As the maid. Wasn't she the maid?
She got her husband to chase her over a well or something?
Oh, she wasn't. Right. Yeah.
Right.
She killed him because he was abusive of the daughter. Something like that.
Doesn't Haven take place in that same Eclipse world?
I think it might.
I think it might, too.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to have to catch up, man.
You should.
That's my new mission. I have to catch up on TV now that we're doing this. I have no more excuses.
So the last piece of movie news we have this week is that Harrison Ford did a Reddit and Ask Me Anything on Reddit, and he says that he not only expressed interest in being in the sequel to the Blade Runner classic, but he has an offer now to be in the sequel from the film's production company.
Did he say he just wanted to do the voiceover or something?
No, he didn't say. He said it says that they offered to let him return as Rick Deckard. Rick Deckard. I don't remember if it was Deckard or
Deckard.
Deckard. It'll take place several decades after the original. They said they would be honored and hopeful that he would be part of the film.
He said, "You Blade Runner."
All right. Ridley Scott has confirmed that he will direct, and the original screenplay writers are back.
Now, Harrison Ford's really old.
Yes, he is.
Get off my plane! Tragedy.
Here's a picture of him.
Yeah. I don't have a problem with him being old. Yeah, you got a photo of old Harrison Ford?
I do. He doesn't look so bad. He's just kind of old, though.
No, but he's old. And again, Harrison Ford can do anything he wants because Harrison Ford's cool as hell.
Yeah.
He can be Han Solo. Mm-hmm. There he is. Look at him. That is not the face of a replicant.
No.
And in the 18 definitive versions of Blade Runner, out of the 40 versions that were released, the 18 definitive ones that are supposed to be the definitive ones.
Yeah.
You know, you're supposed to get the impression that he's a replicant.
Right.
And this just says to me that he's probably not, if he comes back, he's not going to be a replicant. Unless they do that like CGI magic like they did to Jeff Bridges in Tron 2, Electric Boogaloo.
That would be so terrible.
That would be terrible.
Yeah.
I don't have a problem with him not being a replicant. I do prefer the idea that he was at the end of Blade Runner, one of my favorite movies. Blade Runner is just fantastic.
Mm-hmm. Jen's never seen it.
Get out of town!
Nope, never seen it.
Oh, if I do make it up there this summer, we're watching Blade Runner.
Awesome.
Oh my goodness. That's even more incentive for me to try to get my ass up there. Because I love watching Blade Runner.
I have it. I have one of them. Director's cut.
Yeah, one of the director's cut.
One of
the 18 definitive director's
cuts. It's the first DVD I ever bought when I bought my first DVD player.
Nice.
Yeah.
How much did that thing cost you, the DVD player?
I think I bought it when they were still about $400 or $500.
Crazy.
Now they're about $40 or $50 for Blu-ray players.
Yeah, I was about to say, not even, like, yeah, that's how much Blu-ray players are. Yeah. I'm waiting for Blu-ray players to go down in price even more before I buy one. Yeah, I still haven't bought a Blu-ray player.
I'll give you an excuse. Sure. Ready for the excuse?
Yeah.
The entire Twin Peaks set is coming out on Blu-ray, including 45 minutes of footage cut from Fire Walk With Me.
Now, is it only going to be on Blu-ray?
I don't know.
Because if it's only going to be on Blu-ray, then I'm going to have to run out and buy me a Blu-ray player.
There you go. I already pre-ordered it. It's $100.
Yeah, I've seen it. I've seen the, I've seen ads. Not ads. Well, yeah, ads, I guess. I don't know. Links. Mm-hmm. I've seen links.
Yeah.
Is that what we call ads now? Or are they just links?
They're links. Unless it was on TV. If you saw it on TV, it's an ad.
Yeah, no, I've seen, I'm pretty sure I saw it on like IO9 or.
Yeah, one of those.
Or one of the other geek websites that, you know.
You can just call it a banner ad. I saw a banner ad.
No, it was like an article.
Okay.
It was like, you know, Twin Peaks, you know, new box set with like, you know, deleted scenes from Fire Walk With
mm-hmm.
Me. Because this is the year, isn't it?
I'm not sure, but
I believe this is the year that Coop, she told Coop she'd see him again or something.
Yeah, I think that just passed.
Yeah, this is like old Coop year. Man.
I was tempted to go to one of those conventions one year. They still do one every year. They still get some of the people to show up, the celebrities.
I used to get that, what do you call it? Who shows up?
I don't know. No one
like
good.
The giant?
Maybe Cheryl Lee.
Yeah, actually, I was about to say, you know, nobody from that series is like really all that big anymore.
Cheryl and Fenn, I guess, got pretty famous. Kyle MacLachlan's still doing stuff.
Yeah, but nothing.
Nothing crazy.
It always makes me upset when he's playing someone sleazy. He plays sleazy people a lot.
Showgirls.
Because, yeah, I mean, Flintstones. First of all, he was in the Flintstones. So, right there, I mean, that's ouch. But he was someone sleazy in the Flintstones, too. He was like, I don't know, he was trying to take over rocks.
Yeah, something like
dinosaur
that.
Dinosaur cars or something. I don't remember what he was doing. I can't believe I saw that thing in the theater.
It did.
Oh, man. How lame is that?
Incredibly lame.
I did not see Viva Rock Vegas, though.
Good.
Ever. But yeah, Kyle MacLachlan. I mean, yeah, it makes me sad because he is not only is he Dale Cooper, but he's also like, you know, Muad'Dib.
Of course.
He's the Kwisatz Haderach.
I love that movie too.
Oh, absolutely. He's the Firestarter. Twisted Firestarter.
I miss Twin Peaks.
Me too. It was a great show.
Yeah, it's a lot to commit to watch over again, though.
You know, I mean, at the time it was on, I mean, I loved the second season equally as much as I loved the first.
Mm-hmm.
The second season is not as easy to get through anymore. I still like it.
Yeah.
Not as easy to get through.
Yeah, that middle stuff with Wyndham Earl and the chess game was a little strange, and the.
I think a lot of it is the fact that I know it's really not going to go anywhere. You know, it's like the Laura Palmer thing's been solved already.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I already know how it's going to end. And I don't know. It's just hard to get through. David Duchovny as an FBI agent, cross-dresser.
Yeah.
Not Fox Mulder.
Right.
Foxy Mulder. Oh, man.
All the David Lynch stuff from the second season, though, I kind of love. He wasn't in. I don't know if he was. I don't remember if he was in much of the first season.
Not much. Right, I think he was definitely in more of the second season. Yeah, he was great.
But all the yelling, and then he was able to hear a roller girl. What the hell's her name? She was the only person he was able to hear, and that was awesome.
Yeah,
I heard that perfectly.
See, you know, did you ever watch the Cleveland Show?
No.
David Lynch was the bartender on the Cleveland Show. Like, if you get a chance to watch Cleveland Show, like, if you're just bored, there's nothing else to watch, and Netflix, if you would watch it for no other reason than the fact that David Lynch is the bartender on the Cleveland Show.
That's cool.
It's like, yeah. You know, I thought they were just kind of making fun of him. And then I found out it was actually David Lynch doing the voice of the bartender.
I like that. I like that he's willing to do that. That's cool. Not that he's doing much else, right? What else is he doing?
Transcendental meditation.
Yeah, I guess so.
That is, yeah. He hasn't really done much.
No. He wrote that book.
What he needs to be doing is he needs to get off his ass and, like, he needs to finish Twin Peaks, goddammit.
Yeah, there were all those rumors for a while there that he was going to, but never came through. Do it like a comic book or something, at least.
Yeah.
Like Firefly continued as a comic book.
Because David Lynch is a weird motherfucker. And it absolutely would not have surprised me, like, if the year after Twin Peaks ended, he was just like, you know what? I'm going to wait 25 fucking years. When, like, Laura Palmer says, like, you know, she'll see him again.
Yeah.
That's when I'm going to do that. It would not surprise me one bit, like, if he was just, like, planning it until then.
I would have been fine with that. It would have been awesome, but it doesn't look like it's in the cards.
Did you hear about the Frankenfurter tweet?
No.
5 years ago, someone, you know, in the early days of Twitter... Someone opened up a Twitter account, Frankenfurter, from the Rocky Horror Picture Show, and tweeted a few tweets. Come up to the lab and see what's on the slab. And the second tweet was like, you know, I see you shiver with Antissa. You know, because there was that scene in the movie where he's like, you know, there's that long pause. Everybody's like waiting.
Yeah.
And then he says, finally, says, patient. Just the other day, 5 years. After, to the day that he did the patient.
Wow. That takes commitment.
That does take commitment. 5 years. He tweeted those first few tweets that first day he opened the account, or she, whoever.
Yeah.
And, 5 years to the day. That is awesome.
Very. Lynch could have done that, definitely.
Absolutely.
A little more involved than tweeting, you know, four letters, but... or whatever.
Yeah, like Kyle MacLachlan does not look as old as, you know, he did 25 years from now, 25 years ago.
They aged him more than he really aged?
Yeah, they do that a lot,
mm-hmm.
Like on TV, like when they age people. Like, for instance, like Patrick Stewart. Like, if you look at any of the, you know, Star Treks, I'm sure he probably aged at least twice on Star Trek. But there was that one time where there was that flute.
Yes.
You know, after 20 years, I mean, he looked like a withered old thing.
It's just not real.
No, he looks great. He looks the same around as he did 20 years ago.
He's running around hanging out with Ian McKellen.
Yeah, those guys are awesome. I want to hang out with them. Actually, I don't want to hang out with them. I'm afraid I'd ruin it. But I want to follow them.
He tweeted a picture from some helicopter yesterday or today. Like, he was in a helicopter and he was like, said something like he was nervous about being in a helicopter.
Look like they're having so much fucking fun.
I didn't see Ian McKellen in that one, but Patrick Stewart was in a helicopter for something. I'm surprised he was nervous. How could he not have been in a helicopter? He's pretty famous all these years.
Yeah, he's a today. Starship captain.
I think that was today.
He was in Dune with Kyle MacLachlan.
He flew a spaceship.
Yeah, and they had those like weird ornithopters, which were like planes with like bug wings, like flap.
I wasn't gonna pronounce it. You did well.
Thank you. I'm I'll spell it for you, but yeah, I'm not gonna try to say it. But no, I guess I probably did all right.
I think we're gonna end the show then.
Yeah,
there wasn't much going on, but we filled an hour almost.
Yeah, we did.
Not bad.
With a fire starter.
We do this every Monday around 8 at notheshow.com, notheshow.com/live. If you want to watch us do it live, there's a chat room there too. And we're on Facebook and Twitter, Not the Show.
And leave us a review on the iTunes or something.
Yeah, that'd be nice. There's an apps. You can download apps too.
You know, I think my review has never been approved. I don't my own personal review of our podcast, I don't think is there. Maybe it is. I'll have to take a look again. Right. Give us a review.
Yeah, write a review for the show or the app, either one. And hopefully we'll do this again next week. Oh, next week's Memorial Day. Maybe we'll
it
do a show.
It is Memorial Day.
Maybe we'll do a show, maybe not. I'm having a party this Sunday. But, nice. Yeah.
So I'll probably be at John's Monday, but, you know, I'll probably have to be at work early on Tuesday.
Why don't we no show next week?
Oh, I hate to do that. Only because I'm afraid we'll never be back, but we will be back.
We'll be back. All right. I should double check my calendar that we don't have anything. I don't have anything the week after.
You don't do that.
Man. The second. No, I'm good.
It's summertime. We always have trouble over the summer.
We do, but we're okay for now.
Well, mostly you have trouble over the summer.
Yeah, it's me.
My time actually becomes, you know, my time actually gets better over the summer, my availability, because, you know, usually Angie's in Florida.
Yeah.
And I'm just kind of moping around the house. And I'm like, are we doing a show? And you're just like, dude, I am like doing things. I'm just like, okay.
Yeah. So we'll skip it next week and we'll do a show. We'll be back on the second.
Yes.
Thanks everybody for listening. And Mondo, we'll talk in a couple weeks.
Absolutely.
Have a good Memorial Day.
You too.
How's Annie? How's Annie?
Oh, I want to smash my head to my screen now.
That's it, man. Game over, man.